Welcome to Arvind Singh Academy. We are discussing matrix and determinants, and in last lecture we have completed the questions on determinant. Difficult questions have been already discussed. Some more questions on miscellaneous exercise is being given, and we are going to solve them today. So let us discuss those questions. So the first question that I am going to discuss today from the miscellaneous exercise, miscellaneous exercise, we are going to discuss from miscellaneous exercise. The first question is given: prove that by the determinant. Prove that the determinant x sine theta cos theta minus x 1 cos theta and 1 and x is independent of theta. So we have to deal with this question, sine x and all. So there is not difficult one, there is no fixed pattern looks like, so we can just simplify them. And by simplify them, you will get it as a. So now we can solve it. Solution is there. And what is that? We can expand it along the column wise, expanding along C1. We have x into this cancel, x multiply by minus x is minus x square minus 1. Then again that will be minus of minus sine theta, that will be plus sine theta, this cancel. That will be x sine theta minus cos theta. And finally that will be cos theta, if I am taking this one cancel. Sin theta minus x cos theta. So that will be sin theta minus x cos theta. Now if I am expanding all this, then what will happen? See, that will be x multiply by minus x is minus x cube and minus x plus x sin square theta multiply by sin theta cos theta and plus sin theta cos theta minus x cos square theta. These two are cancels out because one is negative and another is positive. And here cos theta will be minus of minus cos theta, cos cancel, sin theta minus of minus cos x cos theta, that will be plus, so it will be plus here. And now if I take common from this, minus x cube minus x plus x, if I will take common here, sin square theta, and from there will be cos square theta. Everybody knows sin square theta minus cos square theta is 1, so x cancel, and what is that? Minus x cube, which is independent of theta. So that is the proof of this question. Now the next question is here, and the question number 2 is: without expanding the determinant, prove that. Question is: without expanding the determinant, prove that. What to prove? That is A BC A square B square C square BC CA AB is equal to 111 A square A cube B square B cube C square C cube. That you need to prove here. So how to deal with this question? Now let us solve this question. How to deal with solution H there, and that will be A B C A square B square C square B C C A A B. So that can be written as, if I multiply by A B C in first row, second row, and third row. A cube A B C, B square B cube A B C, and C square C cube A B C. What I did, I multiplied by A B C. Multiplying. What I did here, multiplied A B C. Multiplying A R1 R2 R3 by A B C respectively. That is R1 multiplying by A, R2 by B, and R3 by C. And there is division of A B C also, because we had multiplied it. Now we can take A B C common from third column. So what will happen? A B C upon A B C. A B C upon A B C will happen, and then what will happen here? It will be A square B square C square A cube B cube C cube 111. No, that is equal to sign will be here only. So these two are cancels because I have taken A B C and A B C were earlier in the numerator. Now what we need to prove, that A square A cube, A will come in the first column. So what will happen if I am using the property that any two adjacent row or column is multiplied, is interchange, then value of determinant will interchange. So if this will come 111 A cube B cube and C cube, then there will be negative sign. Now if I multiply again, interchange these two again, then one multiplies, negative sign will come, and that will be plus. So it will be 111 A square B square C square A cube B cube C cube. That will be the value, and this will be the proof. That is the proof. So proof. No need to write this positive sign. We can, it is understood. So we should not write it. And what that property is? Property is that, that if any two adjacent row or column of determinant are interchanged, the value is multiplied by negative sign. Property is, since if any two rows here columns are interchanging, since any two columns are interchanging, the value of determinant change by negative sign. If any two column of determinant or interchange, determinant or interchange, the value of determinant change by negative sign. Determinant change by negative sign. Change by negative sign. Negative sign. Right, so that will be there. Now question number third is there, and third question is, let us see, this is cos alpha cos beta, cos alpha cos beta, sin alpha sin beta, and then cos alpha sin beta, cos alpha and sin beta, and then minus sin alpha, again minus sin beta, beta and cos beta and 0, sin alpha cos beta, sin alpha sin beta and cos alpha. You have to evaluate them. We have to evaluate them. So the question is, evaluate it. Evaluate it. So how to deal with this question? Cos alpha cos beta here. Solution. Let me write. Cos alpha cos beta, and if I would write sin alpha sin beta, if I multiply by sin beta and add them, then there would be cos alpha cos beta plus sin minus sin alpha sin beta, that is cos alpha plus beta, right? And so multiply this by sin beta and adding to 1, c1 tends to c1 plus c2 into sin beta, c2 sin beta. And what will happen for c2? Cos alpha sin beta plus sin alpha cos beta. If I multiply by cos beta and subtract this, then there will be sin alpha sin beta and cos alpha sin beta sin alpha cos beta, and c2 tends to c2 minus c3 sin beta cos beta, sin cosine beta cos alpha and sin alpha cos beta. So cos beta should be there. Here it will be cos beta. In that case, what will happen? Cos beta. Now let us write these two steps. What will give? The first step will give cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta is cos alpha plus beta. So that would be cos alpha plus beta. And 0 multiply by c3, that is c3, sorry, c3, 0 multiply by sin beta, and adding to this will be remain sin beta only. Cos alpha and sin beta, sin alpha cos beta plus cos alpha sin beta, that will give you sin alpha plus beta, sin alpha plus beta, isn't it? Now c2 will come up like cos alpha sin beta plus sin alpha cos beta is sin alpha plus beta, sin alpha plus beta, and 0 multiply is something which is added to there, that will be remain cos beta. And cos alpha cos beta, sin alpha sin beta minus cos alpha cos beta, that is minus cos alpha plus beta, right? And that will be sin alpha 0 cos alpha. So now solving these two, we will have a splitting, or is there anything? No. Let us see what will come. Cos alpha plus beta, expanding this, cos alpha plus beta, this cancel, this cancel, this multiply with this, that is 0 cos alpha cos beta, sorry, that will be cos alpha cos beta. So that will be cos alpha cos beta minus 0, and minus of this sin beta, that is sin beta. Or I can take here row column wise sin, then there will be negative sin of sin alpha plus beta, alpha plus beta, this cancel and this cancel, then cos alpha sin beta minus cos alpha sin beta, this multiply with this minus this, that is 0, and minus sin alpha into this cancel and this cancel, that will be minus minus plus sin beta cos alpha plus beta, and minus cos beta sin alpha plus beta. I hope you got it. What is that? That will come up here. That will be cos alpha cos beta into cos alpha plus beta. Here it will be minus minus plus cos alpha sin beta into sin alpha plus beta. Here it will be sin alpha minus sin alpha sin beta into cos alpha plus beta, cos alpha plus beta. And finally, this will be minus minus plus sin alpha cos beta and sin alpha plus beta. Okay, I hope you got it. Now, cos alpha plus beta is common from here. Cos alpha plus beta is there and cos alpha plus beta is there. So, if I would take cos alpha plus beta common from these two, then here it will be cos alpha cos beta minus sin alpha sin beta, right? And in these two, there is a sin alpha plus beta is common. So, if I will take sin alpha plus beta common, then what is left inside? Sin alpha cos beta plus cos alpha sin beta. Sin alpha cos beta plus cos alpha sin beta. In that case, this will be cos alpha plus beta into this will be also cos alpha plus beta. So, it will be cos square alpha plus beta, and there will be sin alpha plus beta, and sin alpha cos beta plus cos sin beta is sin alpha plus beta. So, that will be also sin square alpha plus beta, and sin square theta plus cos square theta is 1, and answer will be 1. Okay, the next question is here. Question number 4. Fourth question is here. A, B, C are real numbers. If A, B, C are real numbers, prove that. What do you prove? Prove that A, B, C are real numbers, delta is equal to the value of determinant B plus C, C plus A plus B, C plus A plus B, A plus B, B plus C, and B plus C, C plus A is equal to 0. So that either and this is given. If A, B, C a real number and this one given like and this is equal to 0, then so that either A plus B plus C is equal to 0, so that either A plus B plus C is equal to 0 or A is equal to B is equal to C, that we have to say that A plus B plus C is equal to 0 or A is equal to B is equal to C. So, that simple. If I proceed from C1 tends to C1 plus C2 plus C3, then what will come? See how this will come. B there and B there. B plus B 2B. C plus C will be 2C and A plus A will be 2A. So, 2 times of A plus B plus C will come and we can take 2 common. So, let me write it directly. We had did it earlier as well. So, what will come here? 2 times of C1 tends to C1 plus C2 plus C3 and taking 2 common from C1. In that case, what will happen? 2 times of A plus B plus C, A plus B plus C, A plus B plus C. So, we can take 2 times of A plus B plus C common also. Why 2 only? We can take 2 times of A plus B plus C common from C1. Then there will be, this will be 2 times of A plus B plus C will be common. And there will be 2 2 times of a plus b plus c common, and then there will be 1 1 1 left. And then what is left from c2 and c3? C plus a plus b, c plus a plus b, a plus b, b plus c, b plus c, c plus a. That is left. Now I can bring 0 from this. So to make it 0, how we can, what you can do? You can do that r2 tends to r2 minus r1, and r3 tends to r3 minus r1. Then what will come? In that case, this will be 2 times of a plus b plus c, and that will be 1 c plus a plus b. That will be 0, 0. Here a plus b minus c plus b, c plus a cancel, that will be b plus c. And if subtract this one, c3 minus r3 minus r1, then there will be c, c cancel, it will be b minus a. Here it will be b cancel, c minus a. And here it will be cancel, what cancel? A cancel, c minus b will be there. So let us solve it. These are some values, 0, 0, 0 and 0. So if I would like to solve it, this will be 1 cancel, 2 times of a plus b plus c into this cancel, what is that? B minus c minus b minus c whole square, and that will be minus c minus a and b minus a. That will be, and that is equal to 0. It is given that this is equal to 0. So either what will come, let us see, 2a plus b plus c, and that will come minus b square plus c square and minus 2bc. That will be there, and if I take negative sign common, that will be positive, and this is c minus a and a minus b, that is equal to 0. So that will be 2a plus b plus c, or minus b square minus c square plus 2bc plus c into a ac, c into b bc, and a into a minus a square plus ab is equal to 0. So that will be 2 times of a plus b plus c, and that will be a square plus b square plus c square minus, here what will happen? That will be 2bc minus bc. That will be minus ab minus bc minus ac. If I took negative sign common, then this will happen. And if multiply 2 inside, then what will happen? A plus b plus c. And if my 2 is multiplied, then 2 square plus 2b square plus 2c square minus 2ab minus 2bc minus 2ac is equal to 0. And that can be written as further. Negative sign is multiplied this side, so it will be 0. A plus b plus c, that can be written as a square minus 2ab plus b square minus 2bc plus c square, and c square minus 2ac plus a square is equal to 0. That is a plus b plus c into a minus b whole square plus b minus c whole square plus c minus a whole square is equal to 0. So this implies either a plus b plus c is equal to 0, or a minus b whole square plus b minus c whole square plus c minus a whole square is equal to 0. This is positive numbers. A, b, c are real numbers, so they are different. So if they are different, then in that case they will be positive. That will be also positive, that will be also positive, and sum of positive, three positive quantity cannot lead to 0. And therefore, they will be 0 if and only if they are equal. So this employee either a plus b plus c is equal to 0 or a minus b 0. This is possible only a minus b 0, b minus c 0 and c minus a 0 is only possibility, possible values to make it 0. And therefore either a plus b plus c is equal to 0. If a minus b is equal to 0, then what will happen? A is equal to, if b minus c is equal to 0, then b is equal to c. So either a plus b plus c is equal to 0 or a is equal to b is equal to c. That is the question. Now let us see the next question, and the question is given slightly. Question number 5. What is that? Let me write here. So the equation x plus a x plus a and x plus a, that is equal to 0 or a is not equal to 0. So this is equal to 0. Solve the equation. Solve the equation. So we have to solve, because either the question is prove that or solve. So there will be 0. We have to find the value of x. So we can solve it by using solution. If I take c1 tends to c1 plus c2 plus c3, then in that case this will be 3x plus a, 3x plus a and 3x plus a, isn't it? 3x plus a. So that will come, and now there will be x plus a, x, and that is x plus a. So if I will take this common 3x plus a common from this, then what will happen? 1 x plus a, x plus a, that will come. Now we have to bring 0 as what the concept we have developed already. That is equal to 0 given. So here we can write this employee, this is equal to 0, and that is 0. So we can write here 3x plus a, and operation will be, what will be operation? Let me write here. Operation is, we can write here that r2 tends to r2 minus r1 and r3 tends to r3 minus r1. In that case, the factor will be 3x plus a is a factor, and then 1xx 0, 0. Here it will be x plus a minus x, that is a and 0. And that will be also, here x minus x is 0 and x plus a minus x is a. How I did? Let me explain. X plus a minus x, that will a remain, x minus x 0 and x minus x 0, and if I'll subtract x plus a minus x, there will be only a. So using the same thing, that is equal to 0. Now we can expanding along which one? Along r1, c1, expanding along c1. What will get? If you will expanding along c1, you will get 3x plus a into this cancel a square minus 0. A square minus 0 is equal to 0, and that will be a square into 3x plus a is equal to 0. Since a is not equal to 0, so 3x plus a is equal to 0, and therefore x is equal to minus a by 3. That will be the answer of this question. So solution of that will be minus a by 3. Now there is a next question I would like to take here, and question number 6. What is that? It is given that, prove that there is a question which is given as a square bc, ac plus c square, a square plus ab, b square and ac, and ab, b square plus bc and c square, that is equal to 4a square b square c square. That you need to prove it. So how to deal with this question? Let us see. Solution can be like, if we multiply this, because a square b square c square here, and a square here, it will be, if I multiply by abc here, a in first row, so we can write here, taking abc common from c1 c2 c3 respectively. Okay, so if I'll take a common, then this will be abc, a here, a plus b, and b will be left. If I took b common, then there will be c, b, and b plus c will be left. A plus c. If I will take c common, then there will be a plus c, there will be a, and there will be c. That is equal to, again, now this. Again, if I write here, taking a, b, c common. Now, next step, we can do that r1 minus r2, here, if I subtract a from there, b and c, then there will be which c, a plus c minus ac. Then here what we have to do is subtract, we will write here, the step is, I am writing here abc, step is c3 tends to c3 minus c1 plus c2. In that case, what will happen? A plus b, b, c, b, b plus c. Then there will be abc, a 0 minus 2b, because b plus b will be 2b, and here also b plus b 2b, so minus 2b will be there. Now, if I expand this, then what will happen? If I'll expand this, then there will be something expanding along. Let me write on next slide. ABC is common. What is that? There is ABC, and in next step there is A, AC0, AC0, there is minus 2B, there is minus 2B, and the rest of the two factors are B, D, A plus B, B plus C. A plus B, A plus B, 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 and now taking common from 2B from this, then that will be minus 2AB square C, and I have taken 2B common from this, that would be A plus B, B, C, B, and B plus C, that would be 0, 1, 1. I have taken like this. Now we can expand along the first, expanding along, or even you can subtract. Now R3 tends to R3 minus R2. In that case, what will happen? Minus 2AB square C, and that will be AC 0. A plus B, B 1, and that will be 0 again, and B plus C minus B will remain C, and A plus B, B minus A plus B is minus A. So expanding now, we will have 2AB square C into minus of this, so that will be plus, this cancel, this cancel. Now what will be that? AC minus AC. AC minus AC minus of minus AC, that is plus 2AC. So that will be 2ab square c b square c square and multiply by 2. That will be 4 because 2ac multiply by 2ac, 4a square c square and b square. So that will be 4a square b square c square, and that is the proof. That is RHS. I hope you got it. Now, so these are a few questions from determinant. Now, let us solve some other questions in the next after the break. So, let me take a break, and thereafter we will solve some questions in next video, please. And till then, I keep watching and subscribe this channel as well. And also, please press the bell icon so that you will get the video immediately after uploading it. Thank you. Thank you very much.